Hey guys, I'm back again with another lecture on Class 11, Chapter 3, Plant Kingdom. We have already done a lot of lectures. We have already studied till pteridophytes, but in pteridophytes we came across a word called as homosporous and heterosporous species, right? So I got a lot of demand from the students that, ma'am, we are not getting very clear with the concept of heterosporous and homosporous, so could you make a separate video on the same? So here I am. Today going to discuss on this concept of heterosporous and homosporous species. That means what is heterospory and what is homospory. Now let us start this topic. First of all, I just want to tell you that you know that it is only in three types of plants, that is pteridophyte, gymnosperm and angiosperms, where the main plant body is a sporophyte. So in all the three plants, the main plant body is a sporophyte. Right, so obviously if the plant is a sporophyte, it's going to form spores. Okay, and you also know what is a sporophyte. A sporophyte is that plant body where the plant is distinguished into root, stem and leaf. Plant, wo wala plant ka, you know, that avatar, jahan par plant, you know, root, stem, leaf mein ekdam distinguished dikhta hai, this avatar is called as the sporophytic phase or the sporophytic avatar. Great, so there are three plants, basically pteridophyte, gymnosperms and angiosperms, where the main plant body is a sporophyte. But in pteridophytes, the plants are mostly homosporous, right? They form only one type of spore. Whereas in gymnosperms and angiosperms, the plants are heterosporous. That means they form two types of spores. As I always say, ki one fine day, koi magic nahi hua tha. There was no magic one fine day, ki, you know, pteridophytes were homosporous and gymnosperms, they became heterosporous. In fact, some pteridophytes, they started showing heterospory. वो हेटरोस्पोरी दिखाना स्टार्ट कर दिए, यू नो, अ सॉर्ट ऑफ इंडिकेशन दैट दिस इज व्हाट वाज गोइंग टू कम अप इन द फ्यूचर प्लांट्स. दैट मींस दो मोस्ट ऑफ द टेरोस्पाइट्स आर होमोस्पोरस, वेरी फ्यू ऑफ देम दे आर आल्सो, दे आल्सो शो हेटरोस्पोरी. दैट मींस दे आर हेटरोस्पोरस. नाउ द क्वेश्चन कम्स इज व्हाट इज होमोस्पोरस एंड हेटरोस्पोरस. सो होमोस्पोरस मींस दोस टाइप्स ऑफ प्लांट्स व्हिच फॉर्म ओनली वन टाइप ऑफ स्पोर, एंड हेटरोस्पोरस आर दोस व्हिच बेसिकली फॉर्म टू टाइप्स ऑफ स्पोर्स. Right, so now we first need to find out what is this homospory, what is this formation of one type of spore, so that we can later understand what is heterospory and what was the need of two types of spores. So we know that heterospory came, and this came as a big advantage because after that the seed formation became possible. That is why we know that only in gymnosperms and angiosperms they have seeds, because the seed formation became possible only due to heterospory. तो भाई ठीक है, हम अभी पढ़ रहे हैं दैट देयर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ प्लांट्स, दैट इज पटेरोफाइट, जिम्नोस्पर्म, एंजियोस्पर्म. ऑल द थ्री प्लांट्स द मेन प्लांट बॉडी इज अ स्पोरोफाइट, सो दे विल फॉर्म स्पोर्स. बट इन पटेरोफाइट दे फॉर्म ओनली वन टाइप ऑफ स्पोर, सो दे आर होमोस्पोरस. बट इन जिम्नोस्पर्म एंड एंजियोस्पर्म दे फॉर्म टू टाइप्स ऑफ स्पोर्स, सो दे आर हेटरोस्पोरस. बट सम पटेरोफाइट्स आल्सो दो शो हेटरोस्पोरी. सो दिस इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द टू. एंड व्हाई एट ऑल डिड हेटरोस्पोरी एक्चुअली कम अप with time, because this enabled the plants to form seeds. So let us find out first what is homospory, then we'll find out what is heterospory, and then we'll find out how did heterospory it actually help in seed formation. So let us come here. See, this is a pteridophyte, which is a homosporous plant. So first I'm actually taking up homospory, that is a homosporous plant. So we know that pteridophyte is a homosporous plant, the main plant body is a sporophyte. That means it is distinguished into root, stem and leaf. Main plant body sporophyte hai, jo root, stem aur leaf mein bata hua hai. Ab kyunki mera plant sporophyte hai, to obviously kya karega? Spore banayega. Kahan banayega spore? So we know that in them, the spore is formed on special leaves called as sporophyll. The name itself says sporophyll. Phyll means leaf. Those leaves which are specialized to form spores, those are called as sporophylls. Okay, so this is a pteridophyte plant. The main plant body is a sporophyte, which is distinguished into root, stem and leaf. Since plant is a sporophyte, it will form spore. This it will form on special leaves called as sporophyll. The sporophyll, they contain sac like structures called as sporangia, and within this sporangia, by meiosis, the spores are formed. That is clear. Now on this sporophyte, it has formed spores. Later these spores, they will fall on the ground. You saw that these spores, they will fall on the ground, and from this spore the gametophyte will be formed. You know that in pteridophyte the gametophyte is flat, oppressed to the substratum. It is leaf like and we call it as prothallus. If it is a gametophyte, it will form gamete, male gamete and the female gamete. The structure in which the male gamete will be formed, that's called as antheridia. And the structure in which the female gamete is formed, that is called as archegonia. Right? So here, the biflagellated male gametes, that is the sperms, will be formed. Here, the biflagellated. And here, the single, large, non-motile female gamete will be formed. This male gamete will reach the archegonia by medium of water. And internal fertilization will take place. And after fertilization, this egg will get converted to form zygote. Right? It will get converted to form the zygote. Very good. So, this is how things will happen. So, and from that zygote, a new sporophyte will be formed once again. So, this sporophyte will be formed once again. Now, why do we call as pteridophytes as homosporous? Because only one type of spore is formed. The main plant body is a sporophyte. It will form spore. It just forms one type of spore. And that one type of spore actually forms gametophyte. So gametophyte is also one type. If I try to remove this, this gametophyte is also one type. Okay? And this one gametophyte has antheridia and archegonia. So the plant forms one type of spore, which forms, one type of gametophyte. And this gametophyte contains antheridia and archegonia. That means the gametophyte is not specialized that this is a male gametophyte or this is a female gametophyte. The gametophyte can bear both the male organ and the female organ, that is antheridia and archegonia. So since it forms a single type of spore and a single type of gametophyte, so they are called as homosporous. Now I'll just show you this diagram of a homosporous species, that is how a fern. So, I have already done it earlier, we will see it once again. So, you can see that here the main plant body is a sporophyte. Now, these are the sporophylls. The sporophylls bear sporangia. The sporangia will form spore. The spore will fall down to form a gametophyte, which is heart-shaped. It will have antheridia and archegonia. Within the antheridia, biflagellated sperms will be formed, internal fertilization via water. Now, this will form zygote and the zygote will divide to form a sporophyte. So, here what we found was that only one type of spore is formed, which forms one type of gametophyte. And this gametophyte itself bears both the male and the female structures. So this structure is called as homosporous. Now what happened in many of the pteridophytes, they actually became heterosporous. So what is the concept of heterospory? I just want you to see this diagram and I just want you to understand the concept of heterospory. Right? So if you look at this diagram, so now I've drawn the same pteridophyte. That means the main plant body is a sporophyte. It is distinguished into root, stem and leaf. But this time, what I want is, I want two different gametophytes. You can see over here. I want two different gametophytes. I want a separate gametophyte where the male gamete will be formed. Sorry, that's there. Antheridia. And I form a separate gametophyte where the female gamete that will be formed. That will, the one which will be containing archegonia. Earlier, kya tha? There was one gametophyte which contained both the antheridia and the archegonia. But abhi mujhe kya chahiye? I want two different. Main chahti hu antheridia alag gametophyte mein bane. And archegonia alag mein bane. That means I want two different gametophytes. Right? Agar I want two different gametophytes. So you know that gametophyte kisse bante hai? They are formed from spores. So I must have two different types of spores as well. Right? Now you know where are the spores formed. The spores are formed in sporangia. So I will be needing two different sporangia. One to form the male spore and the other to form the female spore. And you know that where is the sporangia formed? It is formed in sporophyll. So I will need two different types of sporophyll, right? One, a sporophyll which will form the, male gametophyte and the other which will form the female gametophyte, right? So what I'm trying to say is, this type of formation where we have two different gametophytes, this is the female gametophyte, this is the male gametophyte. So we need two different types of spores. That spore which forms a female gametophyte, this is called as megaspore, and that which forms the male, that's called as microspore. So obviously its sporangia will be called as microsporangia and the leaf will be called as microsporophyll. Right? Similarly, megaspore jis theli mein banega, we'll call it as megasporangia, and wo megasporangia jis leaf mein present hoga, usko hum kahenge megasporophyll. That means those plants which have two different types of gametophyte, a separate gametophyte for making the male gametes, a separate gametophyte for making the female gamete. They require two types of spores as well, you know, one spore for forming the female gametophyte and one for making the male. Thus, they will have two different sporangia, two different sporophyll. Such plants, these are called as heterosporous, because two different types of spores are formed. One of the spores is larger in size, so we call it as megaspore, and one of them is smaller in size, we call it as microspore. Since the both the spores are different morphologically and functionally. Morphologically how? This is large, this is small. Functionally how? It is forming the male gametophyte, this is forming the female gametophyte, right? So we call such, you know, life, you know, plants to be heterosporous species, because they are forming two different types of spores, right? So now that you have seen it, in many pteridophytes, some, not many, in some pteridophytes, let us see who are those pteridophytes. One, it's Selaginella, a pteridophyte. The second is Salvinia. The third example you have to know is Marsilia. These are some pteridophytes which actually exhibit heterospory. So let us see how a heterosporic Selaginella ka life cycle will be depicted. This is the plant. It is a sporophyte. It will form spore, but it has two different types of leaves. This is your megasporophyll. This is your microsporophyll. The megasporophyll will form megaspore. The microsporophyll will form microspore. So this is your microspore. This will form the male gametophyte. This male gametophyte will form the male gamete. This is megaspore. ठीक है? This will form. This is the female. पहले ये female वाला दिखा रहा है. So this is the megaspore. Sorry, this is the megaspore. It will form, you know, archegonia, which will form egg. This is the microspore. So it will form the male gametophyte, which will form the sperm. So both of them, they are formed on two different gametophytes. So we have two different types of spores in them. Later they will fuse to form zygote, and the zygote will again divide to form a sporophyte. So here I have two different types of spore, two different gametophytes, so two different types of spores. So this is called as heterospory. But true heterospory, that means heterospory in the correct spirit, actually that is a characteristic of gymnosperms and angiosperms. So first time, elaborate heterospory, proper heterospory came in gymnosperms. So let us see gymnosperm mein how it works. Just let us see how it works. So just look at this. In gymnosperm also, the main plant body is a sporophyte. So it is distinguished into root, stem, right, and leaf. But in gymnosperm, we have two different types of leaves. While some of the leaves, they are green, photosynthetic, they will only do photosynthesis. But some leaves, they will get modified to form spores. Why? Because the plant is a sporophyte. So it has to form spores. Where will the spores be formed? They will be formed on the leaves, right? Not on the normal leaves. Aapne pteridophyte mein kya dekha tha? The normal leaves, they were photosynthetic. As well as, you saw that the normal leaves, they were photosynthetic. As well as, they were bearing what? The sporangia for making spores. In gymnosperms, nothing doing. Gymnosperm mein humne kya socha? I will have two different leaves. This leaf is going to do only photosynthesis, and some leaves they were modified to make spores. So just look at this. Those which were forming male spores, that is microspores. Okay, so this is a microsporophyll. This leaf will form spores, and these microsporophylls, they got clustered at one area to form a cone-like structure. This is called the male cone. So this is the normal green photosynthetic leaf. This leaf is actually the sporophyll. And all the sporophylls, they get aggregated at one place to form cone. Since this is a microsporophyll, so the cone is the male cone. Similarly, this is the megasporophyll, and all the megasporophyll, they got accumulated at one place to form the female cone. That's great. Ye aapka ban gaya. Now come here. I am going to take out one microsporophyll. Maine ek microsporophyll ko bahar laya. Obviously, iske andar kya banega? We will have microsporangia. Within the microsporangia, what will be formed? Microspore. Now what happens here, within this leaf, this entire structure happens. That means, ye jo aapko leaf, jisko hum microsporophyll bol rahe, iske andar bana microsporangia, jispe bana microspore. Now the spore will not fall down. The spore has to form gametophyte. The gametophyte will be formed here itself. Yahi par aapka gametophyte banega. Theek hai? So let us see how it happens. So this will form the male gametophyte. So microspore will form male gametophyte, which I have made in green color. This male gametophyte is also called as pollen grain. Okay? And since it is a gametophyte, it will form gamete. So within this pollen grain, male gametes will be formed. So you have to observe one thing here is, the main plant body is a sporophyte. This is the normal leaf. This is the leaf which will form the microspore. So this is microsporophyll. Within microsporophyll is microsporangia, which had microspores. Now these spores, they turned into male gametophyte, that is a pollen grain. And here the male gametophyte does not have antheridia. It does not have antheridia. If you remember in your starting lecture, in the comparative lecture, I told you that antheridia is last found in pteridophytes. Pteridophytes are the last plants jahan antheridia hai. Yahan antheridia nahi hai, male gametophyte pollen grain direct male gamete bana raha hai. नहीं तो पहले क्या होता था, वी वुड हैव द मेल गैमेटोफाइट, द मेल गैमेटोफाइट वुड हैव एंथ्रीडिया एंड दिस वुड फॉर्म द मेल गैमेट. नाउ व्हाट वी आर डूइंग, द मेल गैमेट गैमेटोफाइट, दिस इज द मेल गैमेटोफाइट जी फाइट, दैट मींस गैमेटोफाइट, दिस इज एंथ्रीडिया. सो देयर वाज अ प्रोसेस, द गैमेटोफाइट हैड एंथ्रीडिया एंड द एंथ्रीडिया फॉर्म द मेल गैमेट्स. नाउ व्हाट वी आर डूइंग, द मेल गैमेटोफाइट इज पॉलन ग्रेन. And there is no antheridia, and this pollen will directly form the male gamete. So, sorry, this male gamete. So, what we are doing is we are omitting this important step. There is no formation of antheridia. I want you to see it once again if you have any confusion. What I want to say is earlier, what would happen? This was your same male gametophyte. Then this was the antheridia, and the antheridia would form the male gamete. Now, what I have done is the pollen grain is the male gametophyte. These are equivalent. There is no antheridia and it directly forms the male gamete, right? So here the male gamete has been formed. Clear? So this part is very clear. We can see it once again. The main plant body is a sporophyte, root, stem, leaf, normal leaves. But these are the leaves which will form the male spore. So the leaf is called as microsporophyll. All of them, they aggregate to form the male cone. Within the microsporophyll is the microsporangia, which will form microspore. The spore will not fall down. Rather, within the microsporangia, it will get converted into male gametophyte, which is called the pollen grain. And the pollen grain, male gametophyte, will not have antheridia. It will form the male gamete. It will form the male gamete directly. See? So thus, male gametes are formed within the male gametophyte, that is the pollen grains. Now let us come for the female part. This is the female cone. So this is the megasporophyll. I have taken one of it out. Within the megasporophyll is the megasporangia now. If this was microsporangia, this is megasporangia. Within the megasporangia are megaspore. Like here we had microspore, here we have megaspore. These spores will not fall down. It will form the female gametophyte. The male gametophyte is called pollen grain. The female gametophyte is called as embryo sac. Here there was no antheridia, but yahan archegonia banega. यहाँ आर्किगोनिया बनेगा. जिम्नोस्पर्म्स तक आर्किगोनिया बनता है और टेरिडोफाइट तक एंथ्रीडिया बनता है. विद इन दिस, ठीक है, वी हैव आर्किगोनिया. सी, इसके अंदर मैंने दो बड़े थे ना, एक को बड़ा एक छोटा बना दिया है. आई हैव दिस आर्किगोनिया एंड विद इन द आर्किगोनिया आई विल हैव द एग. सो ईच आर्किगोनिया विल फॉर्म एन एग. यू कैन सी दिस व्हाइट इन कलर एग, राइट? सो फाइनली the egg has been formed. And I want you to understand few names. The megasporangia is also called as ovule. I want you to know that. The megasporangia is also called as ovule. Within the sporangia, you have megaspore, which will form female gametophyte. The female gametophyte is also called as embryo sac. It's also called as embryo sac. And within the female gametophyte, this is your archegonia. This is your archegonia. Archegonia is present. And within this archegonia, this is your egg. That means the female gamete has been formed. So if you look at this diagram, what you realize is the main plant body is sporophyte. जब आप इस डायग्राम को देखते हो, what you realize is main plant body is sporophyte. तो स्पोर बनाएगा, but it will form two different types of spores, megaspore and microspore. So it has megasporangia, microsporangia. On megasporophyll and microsporophyll, and megasporophyll forms a female cone, it forms a male cone. Now this spore will form gametophyte, so it will form male gametophyte. And achha, the spore will not fall down. Sporangia ke andar hi male gametophyte pollen and female gametophyte embryo banega. And pollen ke andar male gamete banega. Jabki yahan par embryo sac ke andar archegonia and archegonia ke andar egg banega. Now you know that in gymnosperm, the gamete transfer takes place through air. Right? So here, the gamete transfer will take place through air. But so let us actually try to find out how it is related to seed formation. You have to be very careful while you watch. See, this is not, this is green color is the male gametophyte, that is pollen grain, within which two male gametes are formed. The pollen grains will move by a wind. Wind se pollen grain aaye. The pollen will release the two male gametes. This gamete will fuse with the female gamete to form the zygote. Just see this white. Now it has formed the zygote. This zygote will divide to form embryo. So, yahan chota paudha ban gaya. Aur ye jo chota paudha, ye kya hai? It is the next generation sporophyte. Kyunki isme root stem leaf hai. This next generation sporophyte is enclosed within this green structure, which is the female gametophyte, which in turn is enclosed by this pink structure, which is the megasporangia, also called as the ovule. This female gametophyte, this next generation sporophyte enclosed within the female gametophyte or the ovule, this entire structure is called as seed. So yahan se seed girega jisse naya sporophyte yani ki naya plant germinate karega. So what I want to tell you is kyunki yahan par female gametophyte and male gametophyte alag hai, so the female gametophyte formed the female gamete. After fusion it formed what? Zygote or the embryo, which is the next generation sporophyte. And this next generation embryo being enclosed within the gametophyte or the sporangia, also called as ovule, this structure is actually the seed. You know that the seed is modified ovule. Ovule hi seed banata hai. Aur seed ke andar kya hai? Agle generation ka sporophyte hai. Thus having two types of, you know, different gametophyte, see, it allowed seed formation. And to make two gametophyte, I needed two spores. Thus heterospory actually came in. So whatever I told you right now, you can also trace it with this diagram. Just look at this. Pinus, which is a gymnosperm, the main plant body is sporophyte. So it has male cone and female cone. Male cone will have microsporophyll. They will have microsporangia. They will form microspore. It will form the male gametophyte pollen grain. And the pollen grain will form the male gamete. Right? Look at here. Female cone, megasporophyll. It has megasporangia. It will have megaspore. This will form the female gametophyte. Here, the female gametophyte will also contain archegonia, which will contain the female gamete end. Now, fertilization will take place internal. The gap will form zygote. Zygote will form embryo. This embryo is actually covered by the gametophyte of the previous generation, the sporangia of the previous generation. And this structure is called a seed. And the seed will germinate to form another sporophyte. Now I want you to know that we have studied two structures which are basically unique to gymnosperms. One of them being, you know, formation of cones. We know that cones are found only in gymnosperms, right? But in some pteridophytes, they also bear cones. Just showing that these are some sort of connecting link between pteridophytes and gymnosperms. And who are those? One of the example is Equisetum. Another thing, we know that heterospory is actually characteristic from gymnosperm onward. But some pteridophytes also show heterospory. Like you know that Selaginella, Salvinia and Marsilia. That means there are two characters which we find typical to gymnosperms, but some pteridophytes also bear them, showing that actually evolution has taken place and that actually gymnosperms have been made from pteridophytes. So let me conclude what I have taught you today. Heterospory, hence seed formation, though it is typical to gymnosperm, its origin can be traced back in pteridophytes. The female gametophyte are retained on the parent sporophyte. You saw that parent sporophyte pe the female gametophyte, the green colored circle was there. And the zygote, the white colored circle, is found within the female gametophyte. This event is a precursor of seed formation, because the white circle, that is the zygote or the embryo, being retained within the female gametophyte, that is the green circle, or the, you know, sporangia, also called as ovule, the pink circle, this embryo being, you know, enclosed within the female gametophyte and the sporangia, this structure is called as seed, and thus the seed formation was possible. So with that, I've taught you about heterospory and how heterospory is different from homospory, how it evolved, what is the significance and how it led to seed formation. I hope the concept is clear to you. So if you have any doubts, you can put it in the comment box below. Please express how you liked this video by, you know, pressing that like button. And if you are new to the channel, do subscribe and press that bell notification so that you come to know of my, you know, upcoming videos. My next video will be on gymnosperms and then angiosperms and so on. And share it with your friends so that everyone can be benefited. And for you, I have just the same advice as I always say. Take care of yourself, but do study hard. We'll meet very soon. Till then, goodbye and good luck.